Disasters that are overdue, like my gas bill. Let's go from bad to really bad. Oh yeah, I'll also tell you how to survive each one. New Madrid Fault is an area in the middle USA. After every major earthquake, there's been aftershocks that were felt for a few years. There's been at least one small earthquake every year. But if you wanted to survive this, just jump every time the ground shakes and you won't feel anything. Yellowstone is a volcano located in the northwestern US. There's been three major eruptions, one of which was so big that when the lava came out and created an empty pocket, the ground sank in and swallowed, you know, a 50-mile-long mountain range. So yeah, if it erupted again, here's the hypothetical kill zone. To survive this, you just need to outrun the lava, which is already really slow. AF8 is another fault line located west of New Zealand. The last earthquake was in 1717, and there's a 75% chance it'll happen in the next 50 years. It could cause tsunamis and at least a 8 magnitude earthquake. In 2014, scientists from a lot of countries got together and decided to get to the bottom of this. Get it? Finally, in 2017, they came out and said that, yeah, it could be bad, bro. What? You spent $2.5 million and that's all you found? Well, there could be like geysers down there that could be, quote, commercially very significant. To survive this, just get some home insurance or something, I don't know. Arc storm is a mega flood that happens in the western USA. So, California. Historically, it's happened every 160 years, so it's gonna be soon. This is probably the next kill zone. It's caused by an atmospheric river, or AR, which is when the moist ocean air is pushed between two rotating air units. Every once in a while, it pushes so much moist air that it causes a flood. Now, it's really easy to survive this. Ready? Move out of California! This message was sponsored by Texas. Carrington event is basically when the sun farts in Earth's direction. The last time, in 1859, was indeed silent, but deadly, as it caused some fires. You could also see auroras all over the world while it was happening. It was actually so bright that people could, quote, read newspaper print just from the light, which is a weird way to measure brightness. Like, I don't care about all that. All I want to know is if I can steal my neighbor's newborn without getting caught. When this happens again, it'll cause blackouts, fires, and other stuff. To survive this one, you just gotta steal your neighbor's newborn and use it as a meat shield. Finally, we have the Earth's pole flip. Basically, the flowing iron in the Earth's core causes the magnetic field, right? And since liquid flows randomly, the magnetic poles also flip randomly. This flip happens every 300,000 years, and it's been 780,000 years. The flip itself could last a few thousand years itself, and it could look like this while it happens. During the flip, we won't have internet or any communication, but we will have a higher rate of skin cancer. To survive this one, just have a few compasses and sunscreen. Now, I'm gonna go steal my neighbor's newborn. Okay, bye.